Alright, so in this tutorial, you will be seeing how to bring a photo to life. Hey, what's up, ladies and gentlemen? I'm Ignace, Aleya, and by the way, if you like that intro that you just saw, I made a shorter version on that and a complete template that goes along with it for either Premiere Pro and Adobe After Effects, which you can download completely for free with the link in the description below. So if you want that, go and grab it right there. And apart from that, today we will be seeing how to bring a photo to life in a 2.5D 3D effect inside of Adobe After Effects. This technique is super easy to do. So if you're a beginner, no matter what, you will be able to follow along with this tutorial. So without further ado, let's jump right into Adobe After Effects. Alright, so for this tutorial, I prepared three files which you can download with link in the description so you can follow along with the exact same footage as I am. So right here you can see a clean plate image, which is a photo of the background without any character. And right here you have the photo exactly the same as a clean plate, but with me in front of it. And then I have a cutout image, which I actually cut out in Adobe Photoshop. But if you want to cut it out yourself, that's why I included the original file. So what you actually have to do is, when you want to record this, when you want to do this effect, go out, shoot something, and try to shoot on a tripod so you're sure there is no movement. Also try to shoot on a manual exposed image, and also be sure to keep the focus in the exact same spot as your character right here. So make up your setting, take some photos of your character, and then let him leave the frame and take another picture of your background. That's just gonna be an easier way to work with. You can still recreate the background if you don't have a clean plate. I do have another tutorial on that. We'll link it in the description below if you want to go a little bit more hardcore, but it is an older tutorial, so it isn't as clear in this as this video. So but without further ado, I will show you how to cut it out in Adobe Photoshop, and then we will continue and jump into Adobe After Effects to do the effect itself. So quickly, how I do this is I import this image in Adobe Photoshop, then I will go to simply the quick selection tool. We'll zoom in a little bit and just make sure that we draw around my arm, my t-shirt, pants, okay, the other arm, there we go, and then the face, and there we go. We can see that it quickly kind of selects everything that we need right here. And the glasses, maybe we want to do that later because it's a little bit easier with a simple pen tool to remove those. So get something like this going. Maybe also right here you can just select a little bit more. And there we go. For the hair, you can also fix this a little bit later. So once you've done that, make sure you also cut out by holding Alt in between the arms. So you actually remove a selection holding Alt, and just by selecting more, you select more. So. And then also right here, Alt to remove this part. Okay, select and mask. Here we can refine our kind of mask right here. So very easily I will change my smoothness to 30, and I will remove my shift edge a little bit down, so we actually remove a little bit of the effects around my image. And there we go. And then I will also zoom in a little bit on my image. And then with this refinement tool, what you can do is make it a little bit bigger, and go into edge and detection, and then just enable the smart radius, and just go like 5 pixels or something, or like 2 pixels might be a little bit better. There we go. And then just select around the hair. So we're going to do something like this. Okay, it doesn't have to be perfect. Once you're satisfied, click OK. And then we're going to click over here on create a mask layer. So there we go, we have our character cut out. And of course you can go and click on this mask layer where it's black and white. And then we can use our pen tool to zoom in here and actually draw around our sunglasses. And get something like this. And there we go. Then I'm going to close my mask, right click, and go for a make selection. Click OK, and then change the color to black and hold Alt and backspace. That will fill on that mask, well, actually that selection with black. And there we go. So now we have a nice selection of just me without a background. So what you're gonna do is now go ahead and save this as a PNG file, so we don't have a transparent, so we do have a transparent background, and then save that. And then we can jump into Adobe After Effects. So here I will import my footage. So go to import file, maybe make it around 7 seconds and click OK. Then we will bring in our clean plate into our composition, but as this is a photo of a higher resolution, we can actually right click and go for a transform and fit to the width of the composition. So that will actually resize it completely. Then we can also bring in our second image and bring it on top here and do the same thing. So transform for the width. There we go. So now we have our image kind of remade in Adobe After Effects. If we're going to fit it to the work area, we can see no animation whatsoever. We just have a simple image like so. Now what we want to do is actually toggle the switches right here until we see this 3D option for these two layers. What we want to do is enable for both of these layers a 3D layer. Then we want to press P on the keyboard for the background, and we want to kind of increase the Z axis. So we actually want to kind of push this background into Z space. So maybe something like 10,000 would work fine. And there we go. Once you're satisfied with the results, you can increase the size holding shift of your background, maybe overlap it a little bit here of the canvas. It doesn't really matter, but there we go. We have a new background and our character in front. So of course, again, nothing changes. What I want to do is create a new camera, and in After Effects, you can create a new camera that allows you to animate actually in a 3D world. And as we have enabled these two layers to be 3D, they're actually separated from each other. So I'm going to create a new camera and I'm going to click OK. I'm going to drag it up here and I'm going to press P on the keyboard and then hold shift and press R on the keyboard, which will kind of reveal the position and the orientation settings right here. Make sure your time scrubber is at the beginning of your timeline, and then we will create a keyframe for both the position and the orientation. Then go all the way till the end of your timeline, and now we can animate it completely like you want. So we can kind of zoom in maybe a little bit, and as you can see, we immediately create some kind of parallax. You can see that something is going on here, which makes it a little bit more kind of lifelike. And then we can also rotate it if you want to. So it's completely up to you. Maybe something like this. So we have this photo now kind of zooming in, but our character is kind of zooming faster than our background, which gives it that kind of parallax effect, which is really cool to have in photos, in video. Okay, so next what you can do is to make it even crazier is we can animate our character in a very subtle way. For example, moving the head up a little bit, or moving the arms closer to his body, or whatever you want, but very subtle animations we can actually do inside of Adobe After Effects. So click on your cutout image, and then we're going to go over here and select our puppet pin tool. So that's Control P, and if you click on that, we can actually click on our character right here, and maybe right here and here. Just try to make kind of a joint kind of setup. So right here, the head, the neck, the shoulders, the chest, the elbow, and my arms here. So on each position where the joints are supposed to be, try to make kind of a point. Okay, and there we go. So now we did all of this. What we can do as well is we have the mesh shown right here and the expansion set at 194. Actually, I want to set the expansion to 0, and that will make sure it wraps around perfectly around our image. So now we can individually animate our arms. Now, if we press U on the keyboard, you will see that you have a bunch of keyframes created for each individual joint. If you select all of these, we can actually move them all the way till the end, because at the end I want actually to have this animation and this position like I am there right now. Then at the beginning of your timeline, we can actually go ahead and animate it. But I'm not going to show my mesh, so I can actually concentrate on the image itself. I'm actually going to move it a little bit closer, or actually a little bit farther away. We can do that as well. And as you can see, we're actually doing a great job animating our photo now. And there we go. And now if we're going to preview this, we have a very cool animation. One last thing that we can do in our animation to kind of spice it up even more, and that's where After Effects comes in, because we can do a lot of the things in Premiere as well, but After Effects just allows us to do a bunch more effects. So if you go to the effects and presets right here, we can search for the bulge effect and apply this to our background. And here we can actually drag this, if we select this actual dot here in the corner, we can actually make it bigger. And just like this, and there we go. And instead of a positive value in the bulge height, we're going to do something like minus 0.7. And this is going to do some kind of zoom out, kind of a warp effect, which is really cool. And if we check pin all edges, it's actually not going to distort the edges here. But we can also make it maybe a little bit bigger by increasing the vertical and the horizontal. Okay, so now we have this kind of effect, and if you do this at the beginning and kind of create a keyframe for the bulge height here in the beginning, go all the way till the end and set it back to zero, we have a little bit more animation going on in the background, which makes the image a little bit cooler even. So yeah, that's basically it. Alright, so that's it for this tutorial. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, give this video a like. Also, be sure to subscribe to the channel for more and hit the bell icon so you get notified when I upload new videos. Also, check out our website. We have a bunch to offer for filmmakers and motion graphics artists. And apart from that, I hope to see you in the next one. Goodbye.